Welcome back. So today we're going to be doing a tutorial on, you know, this basically. Dialogue stance. If you don't know what that is, well, let me show you. It's a technique I discovered and implemented into my base back in season 3 or about a year ago. 2022. As you can see here, I discovered it after a few months of... I discovered it accidentally. And you can also see here as well, it works. Now, you may be thinking, does this show to other players? And no. It only shows to other players if they step on it too. It's localized. Now you may be thinking, how do I do it? Well, first of all, you're going to need frog rank. No, you're going to need turtle rank. So yeah, it's, you know, pay to get. Disappointing, but a lot of these, you know, stuff is mainly lean towards it. But basically, yes. Now, why would you need it? Well, first off, you don't need the armor stand, but you can just have it for flair as, like, you know, an NPC. Now you can choose your block, you can customize it. It can be any block, but, you know, just, I made mine an observer because I love redstone, so we can do subdivide claims. I'm going to do a lot of tutorials on, you know, ways to utilize subdivide claims, so you're gonna see this often. So I suggest you, you know, try this out too and, you know, get too used to it. So click that, and then right click. And then right click on the same block. It should turn into an iron block. Now what you want to do is step in the middle of it. Okay? And then what you're going to do is you're going to type set plane flag. And then enter message. Now, I already have a pre-made list from Season 3. Let's go on gradients. And we have a bunch of commands. I'll list this in a doc, in a Google Doc, so you can, you know, use it to your liking. And yeah. So, let's do my thing. Or maybe, let's do like this custom one, you know, like a intercom sort of thing. You can do CTRLC or you can right click and copy. Then you're going to paste it here. Make sure you're on the block. If you're, you know, outside the block, then basically it's gonna trigger for the whole claim. And, you know, you wouldn't really want people having that, you know, spammed whenever they join the claim. You only want it, you know, when they step on this, not when they enter the claim itself. So you want, so I can just type, this is an automated message. So yeah. Just enter that. And then, to confirm it works properly, step off of it, and then step onto it. You can also do exit message, but I never really use it. I think you could use it for, like, you know, shop NPCs where it's like, come back later and stuff, so yeah. So yeah, this is an automated message. So yeah, it's basically lifelike. And my docs have this like, you know, fade thing. the same thing that's used for this. It also has the, you know, stuff for frog to goat to patron and helper to manager. I'll do owner sometime, but there's a lot of stuff, but mostly because I'm just lazy in general. But yeah, you even get the gradients. I'll explain these later in another tutorial, okay? But for now, we need to focus on this so I don't get out of track. So basically, that's pretty much it. Now, you can also do... Now, what I said earlier about the entire claim, you can actually do it for the entire claim if you want. You know, for example, if you're doing, a public shop or something, or a hangout area, you can do that. So, yeah. As you can see here, yeah. Welcome to TF2's own tutorial playground. You can play around with it all you need. I can just put it in the description, or I can just put it in the same document, I don't know. But for now, that's pretty much it, honestly. So yeah, I'm not sure what I'll be making on a tutorial next. I'm going to brainstorm and, you know, making ideas this. So yeah, enjoy yourselves, have a good day, and hope this helps, you know. Stay chatting with the NPC, I guess. Okay, see ya.